Hey, fellow beauty finders, this is Matthias from Makeup, and I'm so glad you decided to click on this hot topic. I got my good friend Stephen Dimmick here today. Hey, Stephen. For those of you guys who are wondering why we are in full beatdown, we actually filmed a collaboration together, a Get Ready With Me series. Part one is all about complexion products that we love, and part two is all about how to get these gorgeous eyes. Mm. So if you guys haven't seen that, you gotta check it out. I'm putting links to those videos at the end of this video, so please keep watching. All right, so let's get into it. Okay, because I want to school the children out there watching. I want to help them understand.
The children.
Okay, so if you guys haven't seen our Get Ready With Me series that I posted a few months back, you've got to check it out if you want to see this entire look happening. This I would call an Instagram look. This is something that I've done for camera. This is something that I painted and blended and emphasized the lashes all for the camera's sake. It's all over the top, it's very, very, very strong, it's very dramatic, and I would not do this much makeup on an actress or a celebrity client.
Ditto.
Right? But you do this on yourself because you are a personality. You are a social media personality, and so am I.
This is my look.
Mm-hmm. But this kind of makeup in person is very heavy, and it can look very heavy.
If you see this makeup in real life, my foundation is super heavy. It's not the kind of foundation that I would wear when I'll do the same smoky eye because it's my thing, but the foundation is a completely different kettle of fish when I'm out and about and I'm going into Nigel's or I'm going to a job. The foundation's completely different. It's much lighter, it's much brighter, it's less heavy, it's less intense, and I'll just keep it on my eye.
But you've learned through being a social media entity that maybe your normal everyday makeup doesn't translate well in a photograph. And so you, like I have learned, to apply heavier application because on video and in an Instagram photo, it really shows all the difference if you just really kind of take it to the next level.
All the difference.
And I think one of the things that I've learned from being a YouTuber for the last 4 years is even when I'm doing my makeup demonstrations on camera, if you put on MAC Face and Body, for instance, which is one of your favorite foundations, super lightweight, it's great, I use it all the time for fashion, it doesn't make the skin look perfect enough in high definition. It doesn't take away enough of the flaws or rosiness in a photo on my iPad or on an Instagram. It's almost like you have to wear three times as much makeup if you're going to be just a social media star. That's what I feel like I found.
Yes, 100%. And I can tell you, if you do that Kim Kardashian beat on a regular woman, 90% of women, they will look at you like, why did you make me look like RuPaul?
Mm-hmm. They'll be like, I don't understand why I'm wearing so much. And that's the other thing that I talk to a lot of my bridal clients, right? So I have a lot of bridal clients who will book me, and I'll ask them, do you want to look perfect in a photo or do you want to look perfect in person? And they'll say, well, I want to look perfect in both. And I'll say, okay, well, it's there's a very wide bridge between the two.
Yes, there are.
You can look beautiful in a photograph with a light foundation and a little bit of a cream rosy blush and a light lip gloss. But if you want to look perfect in all of your photos, I suggest that we put on maybe twice as much coverage as you're used to, because a photograph, in my opinion, it just eats through all of the makeup and you can see all the imperfections through. It's almost like you have to wear a mask of makeup. And I use the word mask of makeup without apologizing, because Cindy Crawford was quoted in the Kevin O'Quan book as saying that Kevin puts a mask of makeup on me that makes me look more perfect and flawless than anyone has ever done. And it's this kind of like hyper real face that you don't have unless you put on a cream foundation or a pan stick makeup or something that's more heavy and then powder it to oblivion so that it just looks flawless from every turn and every corner, no matter what light you're in. But in person, it looks heavy. I mean, that's the bottom truth.
Instagram makeup is the fantasy. Mm-hmm. It's the perfection. In real life, that's not gonna happen. In real life, you know, you're going to turn, I'm going to turn into a different light, or my client's going to turn into a different light, and you're going to see a bit of a shadow from where her skin undulates under her eye, because everybody has that idea of imperfection. Everybody, even the most beautiful women in the world, Cindy Crawford will tell you the same thing. She's like, I don't look like what my pictures look like, because she doesn't, because she looks like a real woman, a gorgeous woman, but a real woman. And I've seen some really beautiful Instagram makeups done in real life. I haven't seen a lot. I'm seeing these really incredible Instagram artists who are creating really beautiful work, and I see them moving about, and it looks amazing. But unless you have that kind of talent, it's not going to look good. So find your strengths and celebrate your strengths.
Yes, find your individuality. If you guys out there are enjoying my Monday Makeup Chats, please do subscribe to my channel. I do a Monday Makeup Chat every single week, and I'm doing a series with Steven, a Get Ready With Me series, if you guys want to check that out and see how we clocked these faces up to God's eyes and ears, then you need to stay tuned, because I have those videos coming up. Now, follow us both on social media, at Glossy Girl, at Daily Dimmick, at Matthias for Makeup. I'm putting all of our links right down here at the bottom, and I would love to hear your comments or thoughts down below, and leave me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. All right, we will talk to you next time.
What powder are you using?
I'm using my grandma's Coty powder.
Oh, I can smell it. Oh my God, it's got that smell. I really love
it. You know who turned me on to this is fellow YouTuber Patrick Starr. Patrick Starr was like, I swear by that Coty powder. I was like, I haven't used that Coty powder since the 90s when I didn't make any money. He was like, it's good, girl. It keeps you matte all day long.